Anyways, a different video tonight for a change. Taking a little break from the 457. She's driving me foolish right now. I'll take a little break. Don't worry, but I will get back at her weekend. No worries. Tonight's video is going to be on the Peccom 22. In the last video, we're saying that I was looking for a new EEPROM to replace the current one that's already in there. And it just so happens that I got one dropped off to me today by Mr. Bill. And I'd like to say thank you very much for taking the time to burn off this EEPROM and drop it off to me today. We're going to install this EEPROM in this Peccom 22, and we're going to see if it's going to work or not. He's interested in knowing if it's going to work, and I'm interested in knowing if it works too, because I want to put this thing to use. So I guess without further ado, let's pull the cover off this Peccom 22, power this thing up, and see what happens. Hopefully, it works. Alright, so here's the EEPROM that I want to replace. It's this one here. And we're going to install this new one into its place. So hopefully, with any luck, we'll have a working TNC. Right now, this one is set up for APRS. There's no command you put into this to actually do anything. It's just a set it up and forget it sort of a deal. But what's the use of a TNC if you can't control the damn thing? So I'm going to rip out this EEPROM, unplug it, plug this one in its place, and hopefully, with any luck, we'll get it to work. Right, so we got the old EEPROM taken out. This one's pretty much useless to me. So we're going to dispose of that in the trash. Unless somebody knows how, if you're going to reprogram that thing. I'm not sure. I suppose you can reprogram EEPROMs. I have no idea. I've never programmed them. I know very little about them. But here is the new EEPROM. Version 3.2.9.1, December 21st, 1994. So, is it going to work, is the question. I guess we're going to hook her up to the computer and see if we can get some life into this critter. Alright, Peccom 22. Got the serial cable from here. It's back of the old computer. The computer is a old Toshiba 490CDT. Old as Buffy's goat. So what we're gonna do is we're going to see if I can get you guys high enough. Same time. Don't know if it's gonna work. Can you see that screen? Not sure if we can see that or not. I can't see it there, but let's see. Alright. That I think you can see. Let's get the TNC up into the screen here if we can. Alright, so what we're going to do, we're going to start packet. So she's starting. Right now TNC is not on. So right now it said the TNC is not responding, abort, retry, ignore. So what we're going to do, turn on the TNC. Red light comes on, STA and connection comes on for a second. Now we shall press retry. Boom. There we go. Looking a lot better. Looking a lot better than the last time. I guess I can turn my light off here on the camera. There we go. So, let's see. My, no call. So she's responding to commands, which is nice. Now change my call to my call sign. So now my, there you go, MH, heard, unknown command. I'm dealing with a 22 here, not a not a cam, so it's a bit different. I'm trying to get a, let me see, B-text, see what comes up. B-text, nothing. Okay, B-text. Let's go. East End. My B-text right now, East End St. John's, Newfoundland, DB01MDS. And so C-text, nothing in C-text. In C-text, I put welcome. Welcome to my station. And a few control G's to get my attention. There we go. If anybody connects to me, we'll get that now. C text basically means connect text. Somebody connects to me, that's what they get. So, there you go. Seems to be working fine. What else can the PECOM 22 do? It's an issue of connecting. I know there's nobody on. I know they're not connected to any radio, but this is in a destroy just for badness to see what she's going to do. Connect them out of call sign. Enter. There you go. So she's PTTing. So she's sending. Hey folks, this is the old radio I got when I got the can or the PECOM. It's an old Motorola Radius GM300. I'm trying to get this thing reprogrammed if possible. Right now she sits on 144.390 on the APRS band, and or frequency I should say, and I'm just going to issue a command, a connect command to V1GT-1. We won't get any information from it, any heard or anything else, but we'll just issue a connect with the PECOM. So first what we'll do, set you up in front of the TNC here so you can see what's going on. There you go. First we're going to do a connect sequence to V1GT-1, and you'll see the different LEDs coming up here. So first thing you'll see is the PTT LED, and then you'll get con for connect. So let's just issue a quick connect. I know the bot's probably going to shoot me for this, but I gotta test the thing to see if it's working. So we're going to issue a connect. So we're now connected. Now we'll issue a disconnect. Disconnected. Easy. Alright, so now we're going to show you the whole sequence again. So So basically, you just press Control C, or no, you don't. What was I saying? So press C, the call sign you want to connect to, and just press Enter. Now we're connected. And to disconnect, use Control C and D and hit Enter. And you're disconnected. There we go. Anyways, so yeah, she's working perfect. And again, Bill, thank you very much for the EEPROM. It's working flawless if you're watching the videos. Thank you very much. I greatly appreciate this. Now I just got to get this TNC here. Either I program this radio or program one of the VHF I got to one of the Kenwoods or something. We shall see. And here's some stuff you see on APRS. Just saying, yep, I'm over here. But APRS is okay, I suppose. If you want to go play a satellite and say, yep, this is where I'm too. But I think myself, it's okay. But it would be nice if there was an actual packet node in town that you can actually go, you know, keyboard to keyboard on. And, well, let's put it this way. I'm going to see if I can rectify that problem. See if we can get packet online here in town. And connect it to the boys over in Conception Bay. That's my plan anyways. We'll see how that goes. Anyways, hope you enjoyed the video. All the best, and 73.